Hi friends, good morning to all. Hope you are doing well. Today onwards, we will start to discuss integumentary system, some of the main disorders related to integumentary system, and what are the risk factors usually we'll see in these disorders, and some of the important diagnostic evaluations that usually we use for confirmation of the infectious diseases which is related and comes under the integumentary system. So let us start. Here, first we will do a small review of anatomy and physiology of the skin, because I know that all of you might have completed your bachelor degree and it might be many years, so you might be forget some of the aspects. So just we will refresh those knowledge that we have studied in our nursing colleges. So what you will understand when you will listen the integumentary system, what all the points coming to your mind when you listen this word? Definitely we know that skin is one of the largest sensory organ of the body, with a surface area of 10 to 15 to 20 square feet and weight about 9 pounds, right? So that is the main thing we should always remember in our mind. Then when we'll come to the functions of skin, is that it is act as a first line defense mechanism against infections, and also it protects the underlying tissues and organs from injury. Then another one important function of the skin is that it helps the vitamin D3 synthesis, which is very essential for the normal calcium metabolism. Then some other functions, like it helps to excrete the waste products, organic waste and salt, and also protect the body from excessive water loss and maintain the normal body temperature. So these are some of the functions of the skin, or the which will comes under the physiology of integumentary system. Now we will see how the skin is divided based on its layers. The first layer is the epidermis, and the second layer is dermis, then the last third layer is subcutaneous layer or hypodermis, and it is the adipose tissue. So the first one is epidermis, then dermis, then the subcutaneous layer. So this is the layers of the skin. I have already put a picture about this one, so you can see that it will be give you a good clarification about what are the things inside in each layers of the skin. In the epidermis, we can see nail, hair, and sebaceous glands, sweat glands. Then we will see the dermis and subcutaneous, we can see the connective tissue, blood vessels, and these all will come one by one. This is very important because when we are studying the burns and pressure sores, most of the classification and the management are taken based on how many layers or until which layer it has affected, like a superficial full thickness burn or deep partial thickness burn, and how it affected, you know, what all the layers of skin has affected in this particular classification. And for the pressure ulcer, like the stage 1, it affects only the epidermis, like redness. And when we go to the stage 2, it affects the dermis also, that is called stage 2. And that is, for example, like blister. Then when we come to the third stage, that also affects the subcutaneous. So epidermis, dermis, and subcutaneous. And the finally fourth stage, all the muscles, tendons, and this one. So these layers of skin is very important, we should understand, and when we will see the picture, it will get a clear idea about this one. Okay, then now we will see what are some of the risk factors that is related to this integumentary system disease and disorders. One of the risk factor is like non-modifier, like race, age, because especially when older people have some issues, they are more prone to get pressure sores because of the elasticity of the skin. And some race, they have a kind of some incidence of some cancers, skin cancers. So that is one risk factor. And another one, exposure to radiation, exposure to sunlight or some kind of indoor tanning. Then another one is like more time exposure to any kind of environmental pollutants or chemicals. Then some people, they don't have a proper personal hygiene habits and use of some herbal products or some harsh soaps and creams. that also will end up with some of the skin issues. And another one main risk factor is that long-term use of glucocorticoid therapy. Then some people have some kind of systemic illness, and if we get any kind of skin injury, that is also a portal of entry of infectious or bacteria. So these are some of the main risk factors that is related to the integumentary system diseases and disorders. So is that clear, everybody? Shall we move to a question which will make us to think how the questions will come, or what all the scenarios can be related to this integumentary system diseases? Okay, so here we will see, if the nurse is assessing an older adult skin, the assessment will involve inspecting the skin for color, pigmentation, vascularity. The critical component in the nurse's assessment is noting which of the options given below. See the question, I will reword. The nurse, now she is doing an older adult skin. Okay, she is doing an assessment. Here there is keyword, he's an older adult. Okay, then while she is doing the assessment, she will inspect the color, she will inspect the pigmentation and vascularity. So which critical component that she should concern more about, or that she should not, out of the options given below? The first option is similarities from one side to other side of the body. Second option is changes from the normal expected findings. Then the third one is appearance of age-related wrinkles. The fourth option says skin darker. So what do you think? Which could be a right option in this scenario? See, the first option, they said that similarities from one side to the other. Do you think that this is one of the critical component that she should concern more, that she should note as a priority one? I don't think. So shall we eliminate that one? Then the another one is appearance of age-related wrinkles. Yeah, we all know that the older clients, the older adult, start to show some kind of wrinkles, and that is an expected assessment. So we no need to worry or no need to give more concern for that part. So we can eliminate that option also. The another option is skin darker. As per the age increasing, the skin darker also it's changing. That is also an expected finding. So that one also we can eliminate. So what is the pending one? Only one option is there for us. That is changes from the normal expected findings. Exactly. See, here we can see, from the normal expected finding, we know there are certain assessment findings we will get when we are doing an assessment on an older client skin, that we know already. But other than that expected normal findings, if we find something, that is the one we should consider as a critical component. That is the one we should give more priority, and we should concern, we should inform the doctor. So is that clear? So shall we move to one more questions? Here it says, I will read the question, which of the following changes are associated with the normal aging? I hope all of you know the answer of this question. This is very common and easy to find out the answer. The first option says the outer layer of the skin is replaced with the new cells every 3 days. Then the second option says the subcutaneous fat and extracellular water decrease. Third option, the dermis become highly vascular and assist in the regulation of body temperature. Then the last one is collagen becomes elastic and strong. What do you think? Which could be a better option in this scenario? See, the first one, the outer layer of the skin is replaced with the new cells every 3 days. When the people get older, we know that the process of the skin myelination and proliferation, epithelialization, everything is becoming in a very long duration stages, and it's not same like when we are young adult. So that one we can eliminate. Then the another option says the dermis becomes highly vascular and assist in the regulation of body temperature. All of you know that when the older adult or the geriatric patient, when they will admit in the client, we will always take more precautions in terms of checking the temperature of their hot water if they are taking bath in the hot water, because their sensitivity to feel that hot, that is decreasing day by day because they are getting old. So that also, if you have such kind of a common idea, we know that this is not a right option in this scenario. We can eliminate the option 3 also. Then the another one is collagen becomes elastic and strong. When we became old, or when the client is an old patient, we see the skin of the patient, it is not that much strong with the wrinkles and not that much in a perfect way as we have in, as we seen an adult client. So that is also we can eliminate. This is a very simple question. When we will read, we'll really will understand if you will put a concentration while reading the options. So we have only one more options left. That is if the subcutaneous fat and extracellular water decrease. Yes, that is the thing. Exact thing. The extracellular water also decrease. So here the answer is option 2. Is that clear? So this is the some of the main aspect that can or some of the question scenarios that can come related to the some of the basic part of endocrinology system or the anatomy physiology related topics. If you are clear, just review the questions. If you are not that much clear about the anatomy, or you might forget some of the things that you have studied in the colleges, just read from the online or from the Google somewhere or from any book, and just refresh your knowledge, because it is very important when we are going to some of the disease conditional disorders, we should have the clear idea about this anatomy and physiology. Okay, so bye for now, we'll see you later.